The book is the Hitler's first victims, and it really is about the first four Jewish victims to die in a Nazi camp. I wrote the book not with hindsight, but with what Hottinger or anyone knew at that particular moment. So Hottinger did not know that he was in the Third Reich. She did not know that this was on the cusp of the Holocaust. But he receives this call that these four men have been shot. He drives 20 minutes out to this isolated camp, and he gets there, and he sees these corpses. And he says, oh my gosh, they're all Jews. He goes back to his boss, and he says to, who was an anti-Nazi, and he says to him, I think they are killing Jews. I think the Nazis are killing Jews in Dachau. His boss says, I know the Nazis, and not even they would do that. Hottinger pursued these murders relentlessly. But most of the fellow jurists, most of the other prosecutors around him, it isn't that they did anything bad, but they were unwilling to force the right thing, to make the right thing happen. And it was more the passiveness in German society that allowed this to happen. People wanted to make him a hero. And he said something remarkable, which was, I was not a hero. I only did what my job required, and more importantly, what my conscience demanded. I looked into archives, I think that have never been opened or even looked at, even in very small towns in Germany. I mean, some of the major archives in Munich and Berlin, but also small places like Amberg and Bamberg, sort of the deep heart of Bavaria. When I was going through this archive, I came across 34 typewritten pages of Hottinger's memoirs of what happened that spring. He waited until the age of 90 to actually tell the story, because it implicated a lot of colleagues that he had at the time. And what he said is, they didn't do anything that was criminally wrong, but to his mind, they were morally wrong. But he was not going to judge in his lifetime whether they were good or bad people. I was very critical going into these the memoirs, and I found corroborating evidence for everything he said. And I discovered some things that Hottinger didn't even know was going on, which was an amazing betrayal by one of his closest associates. And I don't think Hottinger ever even knew that took place. You know, the book is called Hitler's First Victims, and it is about the first four victims of the Holocaust. But it's about another victim, which was the first German democracy, the Weimar Republic. There's a scholar who once said that Weimar Germany died twice. It was murdered and it committed suicide. And what the book tries to show is a society under assault, in transition. I did write this intentionally after 9/11, not to say that America was Nazi Germany, but to show what it was like for a society to be under assault, and what individuals or society at large is willing to sacrifice in terms of personal liberties for national security. You can read in between the lines there, you can see that in some ways the Reichstag was the Twin Towers. There was something called Schutzhaft, which was protective custody, which was extraordinary rendition. It was taking citizens and moving them outside of the normal processes of the law. You had Dachau, which was beyond the reach, ultimately, of the normal judicial processes. Not identical to Guantanamo, but you had something that was created within the context of a democracy that really shouldn't be there. And in the case of Germany, led to horrific results.